Hello children, how are you all? Hope you all are doing well. My name is Gayatri, English teacher of Dr. Besant School. Today we are going to have a 4th standard English subject. Are you all ready with the books, children? As I already told you, be ready with your studio book, right, yesterday? Yes, so I think you are ready. Please open your studio books and today we are going to have a lesson 2, Tricky Business. And the subtitle in that is Tom Sawyer, the Smart Whitewasher. Today we are going to complete the lesson also, children. So I wish everyone to open your studio books, page number 27. So till yesterday, what we learned about Tom Sawyer, that he was a very, very mischievous boy. He was always lying for some of the other things. So for that, to stop his lying, even he skipped the school also one day. So Aunt Polly was so angry on Tom and she wantedly give punishment to Tom so that he'll stop lying and he'll be regular to school. So what was the punishment given by Aunt Polly, Emma? To whitewash the fence. To whitewash the fence. Okay. So now we open your page number 27. So before 27, see in 26, there are two purple color boxes. We didn't do that yesterday. So today let us do that and then start page number 27. See that. Do you think Tom should be punished? Discuss. Tell me, children, giving punishment to Tom is right or wrong? 100% it is right. Because anytime we say that, already I told you also, once if you lie, to cover that lie, you need to lie again and again, again and again, which is really a bad thing. If you don't lie, if you genuinely say what exactly happened, even though your parents scold, you'll be free that you no need to lie anymore. Yes or no? So to stop that only, Aunt Polly punished Tom. So it is exactly right thing. So what do you get punished for? How do you feel about it and what do you do about it? Tell me, children, if you are in Tom, not only if you are, generally you also do mistakes, right? So at that time, how you'll get punished, what kind of punishments you'll get and how do you feel when you get that punishment, children? Generally what we feel, like, yo, if I might have not done that stupid work, I might have not had this punishment. I might be enjoying something else instead of doing this punishment. Yes or no? If you feel like that only, next time you will not commit the same mistake or you will not do any other mistakes also. To stop doing mistakes only, generally our elders will punish us. Yes or no, children? So instead to get punished, you be correct. Don't do the works as if you get punishment. Okay, children? Okay. So now, as we already know, let us read the list, climax of the story once. Then I'll explain you. So I want you all to put your fingers on the lines where I'm reading and read along with me, children. I'm going for a swim. Do you not wish you could come too? But of course, you have work to complete. Tom replied, painting the fence is not work. It is not every day that a boy gets to whitewash a fence. It is so much fun. Ben stopped nibbling his apple and looked at Tom with interest. Tom swept his brush gently back and forth, stepped back to admire his work and added a touch here and there. Ben, watching every move, began to get interested in the core. Ben suddenly asked, "Hey Tom, can I try whitewashing the fence?" Tom considered Ben's offer and then was about to agree, but he changed his mind and said, "No, no, Ben. You see, Aunt Polly is very particular about this fence. If it was the back fence, I wouldn't mind letting you try it out. Oh, please, I'll be very careful. I'll give you my apple, said Ben. Tom looked hesitant and then gave the brush with reluctance on his face, but with joy and a feeling of triumph in his heart. While Ben worked and sweated in the sun, Tom relaxed on a barrel in the shade close by, dangled his legs, munched his apple and planned how to trick more of his friends into whitewashing the fence. Soon Ben was tired and Tom traded the next chance at whitewashing to Billy Fisher in exchange for a kite. John Miller bought into the job for a dead rat and a string to swing it with, and so on. As Tom's friends whitewashed the fence, he played in the summer sun and collected a whole host of things, such as 12 marbles, a piece of blue bottle glass to look through, the handle of a knife, and 4 pieces of orange peel. He had a lovely time idling away with plenty of company. In the meantime, the fence had 3 coats of whitewash on it. If Tom had not run out of whitewash, he would have taken away the treasures of every boy in the village. I think most of you understood, children, right? Okay, now you just concentrate on my reading. I'll read this page. You put your finger on the line and listen carefully. Then I'll start explaining you, children. Okay. I'm going for a swim. Do you not wish you could come too? But of course, you have work to complete. Tom replied, painting the fence is not work. It is not every day that a boy gets to whitewash a fence. It is so much fun. Ben stopped, nibbling his apple, and looked at Tom with interest. Tom swept his brush gently back and forth, stepped back to admire his work, and added a touch here, there. Ben, watching every move, began to get interested in the core. Ben suddenly asked, "Hey Tom, can I try whitewashing the fence?" Tom considered Ben's offer and then was about to agree, but he changed his mind and said, no, Ben. You see, Aunt Polly is very particular about this fence. If it were the back fence, I would mind letting you try it out. I wouldn't mind. Oh, please, I'll be very careful. I'll give you my apple, said Ben. Tom looked hesitant and then gave the brush with reluctance on his face, but with joy and a feeling of triumph in his heart. While Ben worked and sweated in the sun, Tom relaxed on the barrel in the shade close by, dangled his legs, munched his apple, and planned how to trick more of his friends into the whitewashing the fence. Soon Ben was tired and Tom traded the next chance at whitewashing to Billy Fisher in exchange for kite. John Miller bought into the job for a dead rat and a string to swing it with, and so on. As Tom's friends whitewashed the fence, he played in the summer sun and collected a whole host of things, such as 12 marbles, a piece of blue bottle glass to look through, the handle of a knife, and 4 pieces of orange peel. He had a lovely time idling away with plenty of company. In the meantime, the fence had 3 coats of whitewash on it. If Tom had not run out of whitewash, he would have taken away the treasures on every boy in the village. Understood, children? So let me explain you now. If you still have any doubts, you can clear them now. I'm going for a swim. Who is telling this dialogue to whom, children? Ben is telling to Tom. I'm going for swimming. Do you not wish you could come too? Don't you wish to come with me for swimming, Tom? But of course you have work to complete. Even though you want to come with me for swimming, you have lot of work pending to complete. So you can't come. You just go on with your work. Ben started making fun of Tom. Tom replied, painting the fence is not a work. He don't want to get cheap with his friend, right? So he's telling, who told whitewashing is a work? It's not a work. It is not every day a boy gets to whitewash a fence. He's such a clever boy that he can immediately answer in such a way that it will be positive to him. So what he said, whitewashing is not a work at all. A boy of my age will not get a chance to whitewash every day. It is lot of fun to whitewash this. When he said like that, Ben was eating an apple like this. He stopped nibbling. Nibbling means what, children? Biting the apple. Nibbling means biting. And he was doing like this and talking with Tom. He stopped nibbling and looked at Tom with interest. When Tom said, it is so fun to do whitewash because every day I don't get a chance to whitewash. Rare cases I'll get such kind of a chance. So why should I ignore that? I'm very happy to do this. Who said you that it is a work? How swimming is, it is also the same way. Tom tried to cover. By listening the words of Tom, Ben was shocked and he stopped eating his apple and he was so interested about this whitewash. Means here, Ben is not clever, Tom is so clever. We should understand that. To make him more interesting, what Tom did, he was doing more interestingly this whitewash here, there, doing more extra action too, so that Ben will also get interest to whitewash the fence. Means he's trying to escape from his punishment and give the same work to Ben to whitewash, so that Aunt Polly will, I don't know that who had done this whitewash, and he will not do, Aunt Polly will feel that he got the punishment and he is away from the punishment. Some other is finishing the work. By the time Aunt Polly returns, the work will be finished. Yes or no? He's such a clever boy. Tom swept his brush gently back and forth like this. He was doing more over action there. Stepped back to admire his work and added a touch here. If some others are doing differently, we too feel very interesting, right? We too feel that if we do this, how interesting it would be. Same way Ben was also feeling by seeing the action of Tom. Ben, watching every move, began to get interested in the core. Core means our household work. So by seeing this Tom's overaction, Ben was more excited and he was feeling, let me also do this whitewash once. He was getting that. Ben suddenly asked, hey Tom, can I try whitewashing the fence once? Please, Tom, give me a chance to whitewash your fence. Tom considered Ben's offer. Now, what Ben want to ask? That was Tom's feeling, right? So now Tom is very happy. He didn't ask directly Ben to whitewash. He just played a trick so that Ben himself will ask to whitewash. And it happened. Now, Tom is very happy. So he want to consider his offer and give him. And then was about to agree. But he changed his mind. Then again, if I directly give him, he may feel that I wantedly doing that. So he himself changed his mind and said, no, Ben, I can't give you. Because Aunt Polly is very particular about this fence. Aunt Polly is so particular and she loves this. If before it was how it was, At that time, if you might have asked me, I might have given you, but now I can't give you. Sorry, Ben. If it was the back fence, I wouldn't mind letting you try it out. Oh, please, I'll be very careful. What Ben said? Oh, no, Tom, please give me. I'll be very careful and I'll very carefully do the painting on the fence. You don't bother about that one chance you give me. I'll give you my apple. So generally, small children, what you do? I'll give you my pencil. Will you give me your pen? Generally, small children will ask. Even you people also will do the same in the class. In the same way, Ben asked, hey, I'll give you this apple. Please give me one chance to whitewash. Tom, he asked. Ben asked. Tom looked hesitant. He was doing more action. I think you can't do. I'm unsure. Hesitant means unsure. Hesitant means unsure. I'm not sure that you can do this work properly. I don't want to give you. He was doing action. Acting. Then gave the brush. But he gave the brush with reluctance, unwillingly. I don't want to give you, but still I'm giving you. You're asking me. You're requesting me. So I'm giving you. But you should be very careful while you do this whitewashing. Because Aunt Polly is so particular about this fence. He was doing such kind of action and gave the brush to Ben. But with joy. But inside he was so happy. What he wanted to happen, that is happening. So Tom is happy. But outside he is acting like that. And a feeling of triumph. Triumph means that as if he won something. Yes, what I thought of doing, I got that. He is so happy that he achieved something in his heart. While Ben worked and sweated in the sun, Tom relaxed on a barrel. So he gave the brush and what Tom did, he went and see, big drums will be there, no? Like that we say barrel. So on that, he just vice versa the drum and he sat on the drum. He was relaxing on the in a shade by dangle his legs. Dangle means to keep both the legs nearby. He kept his legs nearby like this and he sat on the barrel. And he was munching his apple. He was enjoying. Actually, that was Tom's punishment. He need to do that under the hot sun, sweating himself, and he have to do that whitewash. But he is not doing. He is enjoying. And his friend, this idiotic boy, he without knowing the plan of Tom, he started whitewashing under the hot sun. So, and even though he was sitting on the barrel, he was not empty. He was thinking, how should even Ben alone can't finish that whitewashing, right? So how could I trick my all my friends and finish my work? He was planning what to do. Soon Ben was tired. So after some time, Ben was completely tired because of that hot sun. And then Tom gave a chance to another boy named Billy Fisher. Now Ben first whitewash done by Ben. So next by Billy Fisher. And what Tom took from Billy Fisher to do to get a chance for whitewashing? He took a kite. See, Tom got punishment. He need to do that whitewashing. He is not doing and getting lot of gifts from his friends to do that whitewashing. Means that is the cleverness of that boy. We should be like that. So bold, so clever, so brilliant. Spontaneously to get ideas in every situation. Such kind of brilliant boy he was. Then after Billy Fisher was also tired, he gave chance to Johnny Miller by taking a dead rat to play with a string. Miss all nonsense things, just like I've seen these villages, small boys will be roaming on the roads for play with playing all dirty things. For those things also, Tom feels that he's getting many things, lot of things to him for playing. Even though it is a good thing or an useless thing, whatever it may be, he's feeling proud. So one by one, at last they completed the whitewashing of the fence. As Tom's friends whitewashed the fence, at last they completely, all his friends completed the whitewashing of the fence. He played in the summer. He was enjoying there. Who got punishment? He was enjoying. Who didn't get any punishment? They are doing that punishment now. And by giving a chance to every friend, he collected a lot of things like 12 marbles, a piece of blue glass, so that from that blue glass, even we can see transparent glasses, we can see what outside. If you keep the glass like this, you can see the other side also. Like that blue color transparent glass he got. Knife will be there, no? You'll get chalk. The handle which we hold. Waste thing also he'll have. That handle. And 4 pieces of orange. All this he got. And his work was also finished. Now he got not one dhamaka. His work was done by some other, that is one dhamaka he poked. He got many things on free of cost, that is another double dhamaka he got. Even though he got punishment, out of that punishment he thought of some beautiful ideas and made himself like that. So even that Saturday, actually it should be a very bad day for Tom, but he made it a lovely day. Idling away, sitting happily. Idling means without any work, without doing anything, simply passing on the time with plenty of company. By seeing all this, he was so happy by laughing at them. In the meantime, by this time everyone got a chance. The complete wall was washed, three coats of whitewash was done on the fence. If Tom might have not went away with those things, from every boy will be see by seeing that they'll feel something excited and want to whitewash, right? So by after that, Tom ran away by holding all those things. So rest of the boys were left. If not, he'll get lot of things, and every boy in the village also he'll give a chance to whitewash and make that wall beautiful by the time Aunt Polly comes. And Aunt Polly don't know what exactly happened there, but this fellow will be a good boy to Aunt Polly, and he got lot of gifts also. Yes or no? He would have taken away lot of things, he would take from everybody and then give a chance. No? He'll get many treasures, and his work might have completed on time. Everything might have done. But even though now also three coatings of whitewash has done to that fence, and he got lot of treasure also for him. That is only a treasure, right? Okay, children. I think you all understood the story very well. Yes, children. Still, if you have any doubts, please listen to my video once again. Still, if you have any doubts, feel free to call me and clear your doubts. Now about the author we are going to learn. See, who is the writer of this story? Samuel Langhorne Clemens. Who wrote this story, Emma? Samuel Langhorne Clemens. Again, Samuel Langhorne Clemens. He was born on 1835, in the year 1835, and he died on 1910, in the year 1910, he was expired. So Samuel Clemens, popularly known as Mark Twain. Even this Samuel Langhorne Clemens is also known as Mark Twain. What is the other name of Samuel? Mark Twain, and he was an American writer. When he was born on November 30th, 1835. Twain was raised in Missouri. He was grown up in Missouri. This town was the setting of his famous novel, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer, and its sequel, Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. Adventures of Tom Sawyer and Adventures of Huckleberry Finn are really good novels. Even you children can also read them. They are very interesting too. And by seeing this his situation around in this Missouri, that only made him to write these novels. And he wrote many short stories also. Twain was interested in science and technology. This man had a lot of interest in science and technology. And he was a good friend of Nikola Tesla, and she was an inventor, like a scientist. They both are friends. And Twain died on because of heart attack in the year 1910, April 21st. That is all about the author of this story, children. So I think you all understood very well the story. Please, and today's your work is read the same story for 2 to 3 times first. Sit in a place, read the story for 2 to 3 times. And if you have any doubts, listen to the videos. Still, if you have any doubts, call me and clear your doubts. If not, note down your doubts in a notebook. When we have the Zoom call, next Zoom call, you can clear your doubts from me, children. Okay, children. So tomorrow be ready with your English notebook, studio book, pencil, eraser, sharpener and water bottle, because I'm going to give you your notes tomorrow. Okay, children. So till then, take care and bye-bye.